Allergic eye disease is one of the most commonest causes of redness of the eyes, and it affects around 10 to 20% of people globally. That's why it is important, and it's one of the most commonest causes of leave of absence of children as well as adults from school and workplace. There are essentially two types of allergic eye diseases. One is the seasonal allergic conjunctivitis, which is not so, it's not such a serious condition. Basically, it happens whenever there's a change of weather, in either in summers or in winters, and it's a short-lived. The duration is maybe just a couple of weeks, and it responds to treatment. The other type, which is called as vernal keratoconjunctivitis, now this is something more serious. It is associated with children who also have asthma, hay fever, or you know, if they have any skin diseases like eczema, and most often this does have a genetic basis. The problem with this kind of allergic conjunctivitis is that it lasts throughout the year, and it is also associated with vision threatening complications, like because it can affect the cornea, it can affect cause corneal ulcers, and that's the reason this needs to be promptly treated and diagnosed as well as treated. So management options, I think we can divide between treatment as well as prevention. It's important to understand that there's essentially no cure. The treatment, the disease can be kept under control. Now, prevention is by preventing exposure to the allergen, by finding out what the allergen is. You can refer the child or the patient to an allergy specialist who does that for you, or we can, even the ophthalmologist can find out himself as to what the child is reacting to, or what the allergy is to. So prevention is definitely the best cure. Avoid exposure to allergens. And for treatment, it can range from using preservative-free tear substitutes to local immunotherapy, as well as topical steroids. Now, word of caution here, because a lot of patients self-medicate with topical steroids from over-the-counter available from the pharmacy, or even if your eye doctor has started you on the topical steroids, please make sure that you do not keep using that for your child. I've had patients where the mother is using the topical steroids for the child because the eye stays white, and then child has landed up with cataract and glaucoma, which has impacted the vision seriously. So it's very important to not self-medicate. Always consult your eye doctor and get the disease treated. Vernal keratoconjunctivitis has been known to be associated with keratoconus. Keratoconus is a condition where the front lens of the eye, called as the cornea, becomes thinned out and ectatic, and that has been implicated because of the eye rubbing that happens in allergic eye disease. Around 60 to 70% of patients with allergic eye disease have known to have eye rubbing. We found that keratoconus is prevalent in them. Now, keratoconus, because of so much of recent advances in technology, not only is it easily diagnosed, but it also can be prevented by various treatment options like collagen cross-linking. Hence, it's important that the child be seen by a cornea specialist, where a corneal topography is done, where the keratoconus, if present, is diagnosed and then treated promptly.